Drop it.
Hello guys, I'm Sunil and welcome to my channel Unique Developer and welcome to this series of Library Management System. This is the fifth video of Library Management System. I have already uploaded four videos on this topic. You can go and check out the link in the description. So in the previous video, we created this login page. You can see this beautiful login page we have created in this previous video. So if you have not seen that video, go and check out. Let me just log in. And in this video, we are going to create our admin panel. Okay, let me just log in. Login successful. And in this video, we are going to create this our admin panel. And before starting the video, if you have not subscribed my channel, do subscribe the channel. Here you will find many projects related to PHP and Java. And you will find many attractive design, dashboard design, UI design for your project. And it will help you a lot. And if you have any doubt, you can follow me on Instagram and ask your doubt there. Okay, so let's start the video. So in the previous video, we have created this JFrame, which is home page, just to demonstrate our, just to check whether user is logged in or not, and our login page is working fine or not. We have created this home page. Now we are going to design this home page. You can see homepage.java, we have created this. Now I'm going to design this page. So just set layout, absolute layout. And in the code, click on generate center and generate resize code. What it will do, it will, when we run our project, the frame will be open in middle of the window. Okay, and size would be 1905. You can give any size according to your display, 1023. Okay, and I have to take a panel. Simple panel, J panel. You can see here a J panel. Set layout as absolute, and you can see in the navigator J panel 1, and it's available here. Just make it large. And in the properties, I have to change its background color. I want to change background color as 102, 255. And let me just copy this color because I'm going to use this color many times. So in here I want to paste it, and the width, and I want to change the height and width. So the width is 1900 and height I want to keep it as 17. Okay, so that's all. And next thing is we have to add a icon here. So take a panel, simple J panel, not panel, a label. So take a label, put it here, and go to properties and icons. We have to put an icon on it. So admin icon, select the folder. If you don't know how to, from where to get these icons, let me show you first. This is my project, which is library management system, and in the first video of this project I showed you how to import these icons into your projects. If you have not watched, go check out the video, and I will also provide the link to these icons in the description link. You can download from there also. So in the admin icon, I'm going to use the icons for the admin panel from this dashboard, and let's start. So properties and icon, and in the admin icon, and I want to use icon called menu. Here you can see menu, and okay. Now just remove the text on it and move it to left. So the next is I want to take a panel, J panel, and change this its background color, 51, 51. Okay, and height I want to take a width should be 5, and height is 50. Okay, perfect. And from x axis I want to take it on 80. That's all, perfect. And here I want to write library management system. So take a label, put it here, and add here library management system. and go to properties and change the font of this label. So font, first change the background color. Background color, let me take as white, and why not background color, sorry, we have to change the foreground color because we want to change the color of the text. So white, and the font I want to take it as UIU thick light and bow plane 25 and okay. Now next is I want to take another label to display welcome admin. So copy this label, Control C, Control V, and put it here. Write the text as welcome comma admin, and I want to change the text. So text is semi bold, plain and 20, and I just want to insert an image on this panel. So right click, properties, admin icons, admin icons, and select a mail user and OK. So we got our welcome admin, and here I want to put a cross button to cancel the frame. So copy this label, Control C, Control V, and just write X and remove this icon none. Okay, and change the font. I want to keep the font as UI Gothic bold and 30 and okay, and take it and put it here. Now we have to apply an event, which is mouse click event. When user click this button, the frame will be closed. So go to right click, go to events and mouse click, and write here system dot exit and 0. So now let me just run it and show you. You can see we got our header part ready, and now we can use this button to cancel the frame. And I don't want these three buttons on my JFrame. So what you have to do is click on JFrame and go to properties and undecorated. You can see a property undecorated, check it. And now let me run it, and we won't see that header part again. So you can see no header are there. So you can see no header is available. Now we can use this button to cancel the frame. Now the next is we have to design the sidebar. So come here, take a panel event, not event, set layout, absolute layout, and let me search the panel. So panel number 2, J panel 2, here it is. Yes, and expand it. Now we have to change the background color. So background color is the background color of this. So let me just copy and come here and paste it here. Okay, so we got, and the width I want to set as 340 and height is 960. Okay, perfect. Now we have to design the elements. So label, not a label, first you have to take a panel, and I want to keep the height as, height should be 340, and width should be 60, and I want to take a panel, not panel, label. First let me just set layout as absolute layout, and now put this panel and I also want to change the color, background color of this panel. So let me just copy this background color, which is 5151, and paste it here. Now just enter, which is the first element. I have entered all the elements here. The first element is home page, so let me just copy it. And where is my label? So inside this I have label, just expand it. Now change the font. So the font I want to keep as UI Gothic UI Semi-Lite and bold and 18, and foreground color is white. Yes, so we got our home page, and I want to insert a icon. So go to properties, select an icon, and from admin icon select home. Okay, perfect. Give it some space. Now change the background color. I want to keep the background color as red. So let me just enter a background color. Background color should be 255, comma 51, comma 51. Okay, perfect. And the next one is, and I want to change the icon. I want a white color icon. Home. Where is my home icon? Okay, this one. And we got it. Now I want to copy this JPanel and paste it here. And now just put it here and change the text as LMS dashboard. Give some space and change the background, change the image, and image I want to keep as library, and change the background color. Background color should be 515151. So paste it here. Okay, now let's just copy this label only. Copy it and here paste it and type features and remove the icon. Now just copy it and paste it. The next one is book, manage books. Copy it, paste it here. Just copy it, Control C, Control V. The next one is manage students. Copy it, paste. Now next one is issue book. Next one is return a book. Okay, just let me first copy the JPanel. Control C and Control V and return book. Now copy, Control V, Control C, Control V. The next one is view records. Next one is view issue book. Control C, Control V. View issued books. next one is defaulter list. So just copy and paste. And here I want to paste defaulter list. And the last one is logout. Now change the icons of all the labels. So exit, I want to keep it and give it as an icon as exit. Exit. Now I want to change the background color of this. So copy this background color and click this panel and enter. Now just we have to change the icons properties. The icon should be book. There is icon called book. You can see book. Okay. Now manage student icon. Here you can see manage student icon should be. Let me just check here. Read online. Okay. Come here. Read online. Now issue book properties, issue book icon should be cell. Now return a book, so return purchase properties, return a purchase, view records. So view details properties, view details. Okay, view issued books. So books properties, books. You can see books. And defaulter list is conference. Properties, conference. Where is the conference icon? Me cell. Conference. Okay. So now let me just run it and check whether it is looking fine or not. So you can see we got our sidebar ready. Now what we have to do is we have to create another side, which is this one. So take a panel first, take a panel, keep it here and change the background color. I want to select it and the background color I want is white. Now just take it down and cover the entire J-frame. Perfect. Now the next is we have to take a panel. Take a panel, keep it here. And we have to change the layout, set layout, absolute layout, and I want to change the height and width of this panel. So go to properties and width should be 260 and height not here, sorry. What I want is here, width should be 260 and height should be 140. Okay. And I want to change the border. So go up and here you can see border, no border is selected. Select the made border and here you have to make it as 15 and make it as 0, bottom 0, right 0. And color I want to take as लेट मी जस्ट कॉपी दिस वन, दिस कलर आई वॉन्ट, दिस कलर विच इज दिस वन. सो गो टू बॉर्डर्स, मेट बॉर्डर्स, हियर 15, 0, 0, 0, ओके, एंड कलर, पेस्ट द कलर हियर, ओके. Done. Okay, and now again take a label to display the text, and here enter number of students and change the font. Font I want to take as Pro Bold and size should be 20. And color I want to take it as 102, 102, 102. Not background, foreground color, foreground. Okay, now copy this label again and put it on this label, this panel, and enter the number, any number you can enter, and now change the font. Black, bold, and 50. Not bold, make it as plain and 50. And later I want to change this number. We will get this number from the database, number of student, based on the number of student we will get this value. For time being I am just putting a random number. And also I want to insert a image icon on this label, so go to icons, select the admin icon, and here I want to select as number of student, not this one, number of students. Where are the number of students? Let me just check in my already created frame what I want to take. So here it is, go to properties and admin icon, book self, okay. So not number of students, this is number of books, okay. So change the label, number of books, and come here and battery low, okay, no issue. And the next we have to change the icon, go to admin icon and book self, okay, and close. There is our JFrame. Now just increase this. Now let me just copy it. Control C, Control V, and put it here. Again, Control C, Control V. Put this here. Now again, Control C, Control V, and put this here. Here I want to take as number of students, and now here issued books, and here defaulter list, and let me just check the icon's name. So design, not this one, this one, properties, people, okay. So properties and people, 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 okay. And the next one is issued books. So I think the book, the icon name should be sell, not sell, issued books, okay. So this one, and the last one is defaulter list, so it should be list of thumbnails, okay. Now we got, and I want to change the header color, so select, I want to keep the color this one, select the panel, and on the border go to border and here paste this color and OK. Same for this one, go to borders and here paste this color and click on OK. Now let me just run it and see how it looks. So it looks fine. Now what we have to do is we have to create a table. So I am going to create a table. So go to palette and take a table which is RS table metro. If you don't know how to get these components, I have created a video. You can get the link in the I button. Go and check out that video. You will come to know how to use this component in palette manager. Okay, I have explained that in that video. I have explained all this in that video, so go and check out, link in the I button or in the description. So now just and go to table content. First name is student ID and student name. Not student, only name, and the next one is course, and the next one is let me just check what is it, close it, course and branch. So last one is branch, and go to rows, insert a dummy row just to check whether it is working or not. ABC. Okay, so and I want to change the properties, so go to properties and here I have to change the border head color, which is this one, to white, not white ones. Let me the color which I have copied here, this one, copy this and paste it here. Okay, this one, and now same here, and this one I want to take it as white, so go and select white here, and the next is this one. So I want to take it as 255, 51, 51, and now the next is I want to change the font of this. So go to fonts and here I want to select UI light, and size is 25 and plain. Okay, now here I want the semi bold, so YU semi bold plain and 18, click on OK. Now the next font would be YU gothic light, not light, only UI and bold and 20, and the last font should be semi bold, bold and 20. Okay, and come down, we have to change another property which is inter cell spacing. So make it as 0, 0, it will reduce the spacing between this column lines, borders, you can say borders, and the row height I want to take it as 40. Okay, so we got our table looking good. Now just copy it one more time, control C. Now let me just enter, give it a name as control C, control V. I want to give it as student details, student details, and put it bit down and just copy it one more time to display book details and come down. and here enter book details. Okay, only one time book details. Now here I want to display the pie chart, so go to your palette manager, take a panel and give a height of height I want to take here 540 and width is 450. Okay, so this is our pie chart, and just change the variable name. So I want to, before changing the variable name, no, let me just change the variable name. Okay, panel pie chart. Okay, and remember the variable name, because we are going to use this variable name in our code. So now to display, to use the pie chart, we have to import a library, which is this one. Let me show you in my already available project. In the library, you can see we have to use these two jar, J free chart and J common. So in my current project, I don't have this jar. So let me import. So what you have to do is go to the description link, where you will find a download link to download these jars. Download the jars and click on libraries, add library. Not library, we have to add jar, sorry, cancel it, libraries, add jar, and go to the folder where you kept the downloaded files. So I have kept in the NetBeans jar file, and where are the files? You can see here the files are JFree chart. Here you can see inside this folder I have these two jar files. Select it and open it. Okay, now in the description area you will find a code to create the pie chart. This is the code you will find in the description area. Copy it and come here in the source, and below the constructor paste this code. Okay, and you will get many errors. So simply we have to, why we are getting this error, because we have to import the classes. So simply press Ctrl Shift and I. So you can see we have to import these many classes. So and click on OK. Now all the errors are gone, but still we are getting this error, because this is the name of the panel where we want to display the chart. So our panel name is, let me check, change variable name, and let me just copy, Ctrl C and OK. Come here and paste it here, and paste it here, and paste it here. Okay, so remember we have to provide the name of the panel where we want to display the chart. So I want to display the chart on the panel pie chart. Okay, on this chart, on this panel. So I have given the name of that panel. Now let me just, we have to do one more thing. We have to just call this method inside the constructor, and let me run. Okay, we are not getting our pie chart. Why? Because here in the code you can see I mentioned the layout as border layout, but here the layout is, let me check, so set layout and free design, but I want to make it as border layout. Make sure you follow this step, otherwise we won't get our pie chart. So go to set layout and select border layout, and let me run it again. Not debug mode, I want to run it in the run file. So now you can see we got our pie chart, and this is just the demo chart. In the previous video we are going to fetch the value from the database. Just to demonstrate you, I have taken the default values. Now I think our admin panel is ready. In the later video I will connect these two tables to the database when we will design, at the time of design, these two modules, which is manage book and manage student. So in the next video we are going to design this manage books manage book frame. So see you in the next video. If you have not subscribed to the channel, do subscribe to the channel. And follow me on Instagram and ask your doubts there. And if you have any issue, let me know in the comment section. See you in the next video. Bye bye.